President Duterte expected to name in the coming days the successor to outgoing Philippine Police Chief Archie Gamboa, who is set to retire this week. Our correspondent Rafi Santos spoke to the police chief, and he now joins us on the line. Rafi, what can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, retiring PNP Chief Archie Gamboa is leaving it up to the president to appoint his successor. Speaking to reporters in Camp Krami today, Gamboa says he has already packed up his things and is ready to go for his retirement tomorrow, September 2. He also brushed off suggestions that his term could be extended. He says that he has no idea about the possible replacement as PNP chief, and that all he knows is that the president and the DILG secretary, Eduardo Año, will have a meeting in Malacanang today to discuss the upcoming vacancy. He has already texted his recommendation to the DILG secretary, and as a matter of protocol, the DILG secretary will relay this to the president aside from the initial list of three candidates that the DILG secretary submitted to the president last week. Gamboa, after a year in the saddle, says amid a tough environment brought about by the pandemic, he is asking for more support for the Philippine National Police, especially from the community. Asked about his stint facing challenges as the pandemic and his near-death experience in a helicopter crash, Gamboa says he is thankful and he thanks God that he was able to pull through all these challenges. Carmina.
Raf, as he retires, though, any idea as to who the officer in charge may be?
Well, according to the line of succession at the Philippine National Police, the officer in charge, assuming that the president will not be able to appoint a successor to Gamboa as soon as he retires tomorrow, will be the number two man. That is Lieutenant General Camilo Pancriasos Cascolan. He is the deputy CNP for administration. He's also a classmate of Gamboa. And if ever appointed as the PNP chief, as a permanent PNP chief, he will be the fourth PNP chief to come from PMA Sinagtala class of 1986. That is a record in the PNP, starting with General Bato de la Rosa, Oscar Albayalde, Archie Gamboa, and if Cascolan is appointed, he will be the fourth from that class, Carmina.
But as you said, there are two other names on that list, assuming
yes,
that he's
Carmina,
one of those.
They are part of the command group of the Philippine National Police. That is the top four positions in the Philippine National Police. They include the very popular Lieutenant General Guillermo Ilyazar, former NCRPO chief, who is also now the task force commander for the Joint Task Force COVID Shield. That is the implementing arm of the interagency task force enforcing the quarantine in the country. And there's also the chief of the directorial staff, that is the Harvard-educated Lieutenant General Cesar Hawthorne Binag, who is the number four man in the PNP. They are also part of that shortlist, Carmina.
And General Gamboa himself said that the situation is, you know, it's not an ordinary situation that we have right now. So the sooner there's a PNP chief, the better it is for the organization. Any idea if or how soon the president will be naming his replacement?
Right. Yes, Carmina, the president has the prerogative on when to name the successor to General Gamboa as PNP chief. Remember, in the past few PNP chiefs that have sat on the top post of the Philippine National Police, they have been announced weeks in advance.
Right.
Now, because of the pandemic, we are now seeing that maybe this will be playing a factor into the selection of the new PNP chief. We are hearing that some of the IATF members have also expressed their opinion on some of the candidates that may be posted to the PNP chief position. They are saying that they have asked the president to consider candidates that have been working closely with the task force in enforcing the quarantine rules, specifically officers who have been on the field. Now, the president will have final say on that, Carmina, of course, but these suggestions, I'm sure, will be taken into account, Carmina.
And a final point here, Rafi, what about the retirement of these names on the shortlist? Because if you're going to put someone there, then it has to be someone who, you know, won't retire anytime soon and is going to pull through, hopefully, even after this pandemic. What are we hearing in terms of the retirement ages of these names on the short list, Raf?
Yes, Carmina. Interesting that you asked that. Well, the number two man, Lieutenant General Cascolan, retires in November. So that is about roughly about 2.5 months from now. So, but the president has the prerogative to extend the term of service of the PNP chief, like what he did with General De La Rosa, mm-hmm. when he was extended by 3 months before he was replaced by Oscar Albayalde in 2017. As for Eliazar, he still has a year to go. He will retire in November 2021. Cesar Binag also, he will retire in April 2021. And lest we forget, Carmina, there are also dark horses that have been named that are possible PNP chief successors. They are NCRPO chief Dibolsinas, who retires in March of 2021. And Brigadier General Vicente Danao, the Calabarzon police chief, who was a longtime Davao police chief and a close confidant of the president, he is set to retire in 2023. Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Rafi Santos there joining us on the line.